So this is example number two. We're going to follow up on example number one, and we're going to calculate the principal strains of that. Okay? So in this example, we want to go ahead and use the values that we got from our MATLAB code. So we know that these are the strains. So we know that these are the strains that were given in our previous example. And well, for this particular example, what we are trying to do is we are trying to find what is your state, what is your principal state of strain. Okay. The problem is solved very similar to what we did for the case of stresses. And I am going to use your MATLAB code to solve this. Okay. So with that said, let me pull MATLAB. We got MATLAB right here, and you're gonna go to principal strain, the code is online, and you're gonna run it. And as usual, it's gonna ask you a couple of questions. We are working in inches, and let's put KSI. And it says give the value of EXX. So let's see, the value of EXX is, let's copy this value. Enter. EYY. This is the value of EYY. This is the value of EZZ. Gamma, this is what you get in a state of strain, so this is fine. This is the state of strain, and all others were zero. Okay, and then when you solve this problem, you can see that the problem will give you your, be giving the values. The only reason you get zero, this is very, very small. We can probably fix that and make sure you get the real value, but this is not so much what we are looking for than what we are looking for the values. So when if you open the file here called principal strains, okay, principal strains, once in a while you may have to delete the output file because it's just funky stuff, but this is just state of strain. And then calculate your strain invariance. Just remember the same concept in stress invariance is the strain invariance. So it calculates all this for you. And when it solves this, you can see that, yeah, something is not right here. It gives you all zero strains. I will fix that in a second. Okay. The problem that was in the code was basically, I was truncating the numbers because it was meant for stresses. In this case, we don't need to truncate. The numbers are very, very, very small. So what you can see that now when you solve this and you solve for this, you're going to see that now you do get the values. It's now all bound by those values. And so you can see you're going to get, this is all microns. This is very, very small. So these are your strains, your principal strains, and this is the overall shear. And then now you can see that Mohr circle is actually giving you values. Before I was truncating this to two decimal points, that's what you're giving zero, but now it gives you the full value. So this is what you have for the Mohr circle as well as your principal strains. So this concludes this topic, and